In this video, we're going to pick up where we left off in the last video with the similar right triangles worksheet on the KutaSoftware website within the geometry section. And quickly, I'll review that there's a theorem that says that the altitude within a right triangle, as long as that altitude stems from the vertex of the 90 degree angle, it will create two smaller triangles which are similar to that larger triangle. So all three triangles are similar. Our altitude in number 7 is 12. So 12 over 16, the shorter side of one of the smaller triangles over the larger side, is going to be equal to the shorter side of one of the smaller triangles, x, over the longer side or longer leg of that triangle, 12. Cross multiplying, 12 times 12 will equal 16 times x, or 16x. 12 times 12 is 144. That's equal to 16x. And when I divide by 16, I'll get that 9 is equal to x. So 9 is the indicated length in number 7. In number 8, setting up my proportion, I'll have that this altitude of 48 over 64 is equal to x over 48. The shorter leg of one triangle over the longer leg is going to be proportional to the shorter leg over the longer leg of that other similar triangle. Cross multiplying, 48 times 48 is equal to 64 times x, or 64x. 48 times 48 is 2,304, and that's equal to 64x. When I divide both sides by 64, I'll get that x is equal to 36. So 36 is my solution in number 8. In number 9, x is a hypotenuse of that larger triangle. So I'll take the hypotenuse of my largest triangle over the shorter leg, 60. That's going to be proportional to the hypotenuse of my smaller triangle over the shorter side, 36. Cross multiplying, x times 36 equals 60 times 60. So 36 times x is going to be equal to 60 times 60, which is 3,600. So when I divide by 36, I'll get that x is equal to 100. So 100 is my solution in number 9, and that happens to be the length of the large hypotenuse. And number 10, again, x is my hypotenuse. So I'll have the hypotenuse of my larger triangle over the longer side, 7 times the square root of 33, and that's going to be proportional to the hypotenuse of one of the shorter triangles, which is 7 square root of 33 over the longer leg of that triangle, 33. Cross multiplying, we'll have x times 33 equal to 7 square root of 33 times 7 square root of 33. So 33x equals 7 times 7 times the square root of 33 times the square root of 33 is 33. When I divide both sides by 33, my 33s will cancel out on each side. So x is going to be equal to 7 times 7. So x is 49. 49 is my solution in number 10. Also, feel free to multiply out 7 times 7 times 33 and then divide by 33. I just knew that my 33s would cancel out, so I divided before I took the time to multiply so that I could do the multiplication in my head. And number 11, x again is our hypotenuse. So x over 14 times the square root of 6 is going to be equivalent to the hypotenuse of that smaller triangle, 14 times the square root of 6, over the side that corresponds in the larger triangle, which is 24. So I'll have 24x equal to 14 square root of 6 times 14 square root of 6. Now, simplifying, I'll have 24x equal to 14 times 14, which is 196, times the square root of 6 times the square root of 6, which is 6. So when I divide by 24, I'll have x equal to 196 times 6, which is 1,176, And when I divide that by 24, I'll get 49. So x equals 49 and number 11. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 12. In number 12, you can see that I have the long leg and the short leg of one small triangle, and the long leg and short leg of the other small triangle. So I'll say that the long leg x over the short leg 6 times the square root of 13 from this triangle over here, that's going to be proportional to the long leg over the short leg in the second triangle, which now my 6 times the square root of 13 is in the numerator, and I'll have 13 in the denominator. Now I'll cross multiply. X times 13 is going to be equal to 6 times the square root of 13 times 6 times the square root of 13. So 13x equals 6 times 6, which is 36, times the square root of 13 times the square root of 13, which will be times a positive 13. Now, as opposed to multiplying this out, I'm just going to divide by 13, and my 13s will cancel out, and I'll get that x is equal to 36. So 36 is my solution in number 12. Go ahead, click that subscribe button, and give me a thumbs up on this video. Join me in the next video, where I'll finish out this worksheet completing numbers 13 through 18.